Hello everyone, HBI Guys Model Workshop back here with another kit review for you. This is of Academy's Da Vinci Flying Machine from the Da Vinci Machines series. There are a couple companies that have been putting these out, and they've been making them for a while, and they keep introducing new ones, and I just love them. These are snap together kits. They do not require glue or paint, but for us more advanced modelers, you can glue and some of the parts, and you can paint them, of course, and weather them so that they look like real wood, real metal, real antique devices. Now, the coolest thing about most of these Da Vinci kits is that they also move after you assemble them, which isn't something that's very common with other model kits. A lot of times you put a model kit together and it's just a static model. It does nothing. This kit you could get for a kid for less than 20 bucks. I got this online from my favorite online hobby shop, Tower Hobbies. It was like $17.96, and it's a steal for the cool things you get out of it. When you get it all together, you can actually wind it up with a spring mechanism that's included right here on the side and use this little lever here, and you can actually make the wings go up and down, as his illustrations would have proven. Now, I just love these things. That Academy makes these, and another company makes their own version of them, and that company is called Elenco. So if Academy doesn't have one that you like, then go and look at Elenco, and they've got all different versions. They even have some of the same versions, but they make them look a little different, so you could collect them all if you want. Now, let's take a look at everything that's in the box in this cool little Da Vinci kit. Here is the small instruction manual. There's not much to it at all, because this is a very quick building kit. This would definitely be one to start a kit out on, because the instructions are very plain. Everything, all the parts are large. There's no teeny tiny parts in this kit at all, and everything is going to just press together. They could build one, you could build another one, weather it, and paint it up to make it look pretty awesome. You can see the directions in there, show you how to put together the gearbox, the base, the control arms, and the little twist spring mechanism. And then on the back, it tells you how to assemble the wings and the tail, put the plaque on. It even comes with a plaque that you can paint up to look pretty cool, and then how to wind it up and operate the lever to make the wings go up and down. Now, here's a little tip, okay? If the wings move too fast for you because that spring's kind of strong, or if it's just like, you know, sometimes those spring-loaded things, I haven't screwed around with this, but if it does move a little fast, all you have to do is find some plastic safe grease and put it on the external gears. And that will bind up the gear mechanism enough. It won't ruin it as long as it's plastic safe grease. Cut a piece of sprue off, put a dab of grease on the work table and dip that sprue in it and come back a day later. If you don't see some of the sprue melting off, you know it's plastic safe grease. And if you ruin your model by using the wrong grease, it's not my fault. If you put that thick grease on the gears, even though people think, well, grease or lubrication speeds up gears, it does in certain times reduces friction. But if you put a really thick grease on there, like the consistency of a Vaseline petroleum jelly, as long as that doesn't eat the plastic, I haven't tested it on this plastic, that should gum up those gears enough to slow down those wings so that it looks a little cooler so you can watch it happen. Just a little friendly tip from Uncle Chris. Now, one of the first things in the kit is this device here. And this is the spring-loaded mechanism. It's all assembled for you, and you can see it moves pretty quick. But of course, it doesn't have any resistance, and it's not against the other gears. So we don't know how fast that's going to be once we assemble it. But if it's too fast, just go with that thicker grease on there. And that's all pre-assembled for you. That'll just push lock right into place so that you can wind up the machine and make it work. So that's pretty cool, a model that actually does something. This model consists of two sprues of plastic, and that is it. There's not a whole lot to it. This is the black sprue, and we have one more sprue left. The black sprue is going to have the nice base, the gears, the brace mechanisms, your switches, your nice plaque. Put the hand behind there, let it focus. That can be painted up, highlighted, and then just lightly brush across there. Those letters are pretty shallow, but you'll still be able to get them to stand out or use a paint pen. And then you've got some more of the larger gears and the cogs and the different traps and the clockwork mechanism. You can see all the parts are molded well, very clean. The holes and the pivot balls are in there perfectly. So everything should fit nicely. There shouldn't be a lot of binding. All you need to do is, like when you cut out this big cog wheel, just make sure that you gently sand any remaining sprue residue off the tips of those so that she moves smoothly. Same with this gear wheel here, this cog wheel. You can see, based on the size of the pins here and the pins here, these two are going to line up, and then it's got another mechanism here, and it's just all kinds of cool. You know, you can see that is going to line up with the inner part, and it's just all sorts of awesome. Now, it does have, ejector pin marks or whatever on there. It really doesn't matter. Just paint it up. You know, you can sand those off, I guess, if you want. Well, when you put those together, just make sure you sand off those ends gently. Don't clip off too much plastic, or you might skip a cog and make it operate funny. The last, and yep, the last parts tree is right there, the wood parts. And the plastic does look relatively like wood. It's got a nice texture to it. It is molded well. It is clean. A little bit of weathering detail painting will make this really shine and look like actual wood device that you have built. Give it a little dust effect with some Tamiya dust paint. And it'll look like it's been sitting on your shelf in your workshop for decades. Beautiful wing structure, molded very well. Very well. And of course, you'll be cutting all those free so that it's just a very delicate wing. And another cool thing you could do, if you can slow down the mechanism if it's not too fast, on the tail and on these wings, when you get it all together, is you could wet some tissue paper, or if you're really, really careful, some Kleenex, but some very thin tissue paper wet with white glue, a diluted mixture of white glue, about 50%, half water, half white Elmer's glue. And you could drape some linen-colored tissue paper over these when you were done, and that would dry up to look like a fabric wing. Obviously, it wouldn't have flown with just the wooden ribs, so they would have needed to coat it. And in those days, way back when Da Vinci was around, they would have just used a thin, like a muslin cloth, a cheesecloth, a thin fabric. So if you used a thin linen-colored tissue paper, or if you dyed some tissue paper, or white tissue paper sprayed with a little bit of a dirt look paint to it real lightly, you could put that on there with white glue and actually simulate the fabric covering that they would have had on the tail and the wings. Once again, if you just want to throw this at the kid for a weekend, they're going to get it done. They're going to have a great time with it. Us experienced modelers would have a lot more to do and a lot more fun with it. It's a beautiful kit. Everything is molded correctly, so obviously it's going to go together quite easily. And at about $18 at hobby shops and online, I think it's worth every buck, mainly because it's going to be fun. Once again, thanks for watching HBI Guys Model Workshop. Feel free to subscribe, comment below, give suggestions or ideas. I always like hearing from you guys, and thanks for watching.